Now let's take a look at another way we can view our apps, and that is through the app library. With the app library, we're able to view all of our apps that are installed on the iPad without seeing them through a home screen. We can even view them in a list. Let's take a look at this app library on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the app library on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. So how do we view this app library? Well, basically, we need to go to the last home screen, and then we swipe over to the left one more time. So if we look here, I am on the second home screen. So now I just swipe, and then I swipe again. Now I'm on the last home screen. And since I'm on the last home screen, when I swipe over to the left again, what it's going to do is it's going to show me this app library. Now, another way of accessing it is through an app icon. This is in the dock. So I'm going to swipe over to the right, and it's going to bring me back to my home screens. So I swipe over to the right, and I'm back on my home screen. If we look at the dock, you're going to see we have this icon here on the far right. This is another way of accessing the app library. So when you tap on it, it brings you to the app library. So with this method, I could be on the first home screen, and I want to go to the app library. Basically, I just tap on this, and I'm looking at my app library. I no longer have to go to that last home screen. Now, this can be turned off. So if you don't see it, what you need to do is you need to go over here to the settings, and then what we do is we go here to our home screen and app library, and you're going to see an option here to show the app library in the dock. So if you don't see that, just go to your home screen and app library settings, and then you can turn that on. Once you turn that on, you no longer have to go to the last home screen. You can just tap on this. All right, so now we know how to get at the app library. Let's take a look at the different views. When I tap on it, I'm looking at all of my apps. So if they're not on any home screen, they're going to still be in this app library. If that app is installed on your iPad, it will show up in this app library. Every app. All right, so what am I looking at here? Well, the first thing we can do is we can search the app library. When I tap on that, I can type in what I'm searching for. So let's go with Find My, and you're going to see that it found the app here. So we can easily search that just by going over to the top. In addition to that, our default view for the app library is a folder view. So all of these are different folders. You're going to see I can view all of my recently added apps. I can also view all of my apps that are categorized as entertainment. Now, we cannot change these folders. These are folders are set by the developer. So when they submit an app, they can tell what category it is in, and that is where it lies in here. So we can't change the category or the folders that these apps are in. So if you want to change them, there's really not a whole lot you can do outside of contacting the developer. Okay, so how do we open these? Well, there's a little bit of a trick to it. If we look at this icon here, I want to see all of my recently added apps. Well, if we look at this, you're going to see that the two top icons and the icon on the left, the lower left, are larger than the one in the lower right. It's almost like we have a subfolder within there. Well, basically what this does is if we tap on any one of the larger icons, so if I tap on Preview here, it's going to open up that app. I tap on Settings here. It's going to open up that app. So how do we open up the folder? Well, what we need to do is we need to go to the subset here. When I tap on those icons in the lower right-hand corner of a folder, then it'll open up that folder. So now when I tap on that, I can see all of my recently added apps. To close the folder, we just tap anywhere outside here, and it closes it. So if I wanted to look at all the apps in here, what do? I tap in this area here. I tap, and now I can see all the apps in there. Tap again anywhere outside of an icon, and it brings me back to that folder list. So that's our folder view. We do have another view, and I actually prefer this view. I wish they could make this the default view or let us set what the default view is. We have a list view. To view our apps in alphabetical order in a list, all we do is just swipe down, and when we do, we can see them all on a list. So it's almost like we're searching. Remember, we saw this, or you might have noticed that we saw this when we searched. So now what I'm able to do is just swipe up to find my app and then tap on it to open it up. To get back to the folder view, we just tap outside here, and it brings us back to the folder view. To get outside of the app library, all I do is just swipe over to the right. Okay, so that's our app library. Now, let's say you wanted to move an app from this app library over to a home screen. How can you do that? Well, basically, just long press and drag it. So I have the camera app here. I want to move that over to my home screen. I long press, and I drag it, and I can move it onto any one of my home screens. So that's basically all we have to do. Long press on it and drag it. So that is the app library, where you can see all of our apps that are installed on the iPad. We access this by going to the very last home screen and swiping to the left one more time, and then you're going to be in your home screen. You can also tap on the home screen icon, which is located in the dock. Once you're in your app library, you'll see all of your apps categorized by folders, and if you swipe down, you can view them as a list. And then, of course, you can always drag an app outside of that app library, and it'll install it onto a home screen. It'll still keep it in the app library, but it'll also be on that home screen. So that's how we work with the app library on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You could subscribe to my channel. You could share it with your friends and family. I also have a couple of other options for you. I have a site called Dan's Tutorials. It has not only more videos, but it has an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. When you become a member, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member of that site, you have access to all of those videos. I take out all of the ads of the videos, and you have access to that AI assistant as well as my classes and webinars. I also have another option. If you don't like memberships or subscriptions and you just want to take a course, you can go to dansonlinecourses.com. Over there, I have courses on various devices from Apple. As of this recording, it is just the iPhone, but I plan on adding this video along with several others to an iPad course as well as a Mac course down the road. So check out Dan's Online Courses for more information on that. With either one, you're helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So if you become a member or you buy one of my courses, you are helping support a small business. And as always, thanks for watching.